We talk about image appearance. So we have a hyperechoic, hypoechoic, and then an anechoic, and then isoechoic. So we'll go through tissues, and what we'll say is we'll explain it, the echo texture as well as the echogenicity. We talk about image appearance. So we have a hyperechoic, which is a large difference between the impedance. So this beam is strongly reflected and you have a very bright echo. And it's just going to be this bright white line. Usually that's how bone appears. Hypoechoic, a very weak or low echo signal, like fluid. And then an anechoic, meaning it's completely black, meaning that there's shadowing posterior because no echoes are extending beyond the interface. Don't forget, if you want more about the business of orthobiologics, I have a podcast, or you can go on my website, the business of orthobiologics, and tune in. So when you see this bright white, that's bone, and black shadow behind it, that's anechoic. And then isoechoic is equal echogenicity to these adjacent soft tissues, just as in the other picture. So we'll go through tissues, and what we'll say is we'll explain it, the echo texture as well as the echogenicity. So this is normal tendon behind along the arrows. This is actually patellar tendon. And this is a hyperechoic, meaning a little bit brighter white, with a fibular echo texture. So there's densely packed fibers, and this is contiguous. So tendon goes from bone to muscle. We call the patellar tendon a tendon, but indeed it goes from bone to bone. So maybe calling it a patellar ligament may be more proper, but that's neither here nor there. And this is imaged, most tendons are best imaged on long axis. And you really are able to see distal, you know, if you're an ultrasonographer, distal is to the right and proximal is to the left through here. And so this is patella, this is tibia. And so that's just a way that ultrasonographers or angle injection-based therapy physicians sometimes orient the patient differently. This is normal muscle. So this is hypoechoic. So that tissue is separated by a hyperechoic fibroadipose septae and paramecium that surrounds those hyperechoic muscle bundles. And then you see down below, you're going to have that acoustic shadowing with maybe some posterior reverberation because it's nice and smooth and flat. But you can see these are the striations, just like normal muscle. And then you can see these hyperechoic paramecium or the fibroadipose septae. So that's normal muscle appearance. And these are just pattern recognition, and you'll get used to seeing these. So next is cartilage. There's two types of cartilage. There's the hyaline cartilage, which is hypoechoic, and then the fibrocartilage, like the labrum, which is hyperechoic. So this is a shoulder, and this is the humerus, and the overlying is that dark stripe, called, and that's the hyaline cartilage. It's a hypoechoic, and then this is the labrum, and that's that fibrocartilage, and it's hyperechoic. And then if you look, you can also see the dermis and the epidermis, and then hypoechoic septae down below, or musculature as well in cross section, so not in long axis. This is ligament, so bone to bone connection. This is femur and tibia. This is an MCL, and it looks similar to tendon, and it is hyperechoic, but it's a little bit more compact than the tendons, as you would expect. And you can always make sure that you have this compact linear hyperechoic structure from bone to bone connection is ligament. Next is nerve. So nerve fascicles are hyperechoic, and then you have hyperechoic fat surrounding them, and it displays in a honeycomb or speckled appearance because of the mixture in the hyper and hypoechoic relative to each other. And so when we take a look at this next view, we see that this is median nerve in short axis or in cross section, and this is median nerve in long axis. And so you can see this beautiful honeycombing. Next to it is a tendon, but this honeycombing, hypo and hyperechoic texture, is a honeycomb appearance, and that's the median nerve. And those nerves will appear different from the fibular texture of the tendons or ligaments, but on long axis view, it is sometimes quite difficult to identify the difference. So these are our ultrasound textbook references. Please, if you're wanting more guidelines, the AIUM guidelines is a great guideline. The ESSR is also a great guideline to be able to go ahead and look online, and they can kind of run through all of that ultrasound examination. And then don't forget, if you want more about the business of Orthobiologics, I have a podcast, or you can go on my website, The Business of Orthobiologics, and tune in. Otherwise, thanks so much. I will see you next time.